Hi, I'm Nathan Redmond, play for Southampton Football Club, and you're watching Uncut on the Premier League YouTube channel.
This is Redmond. Shot's on now, and there is the goal.
So to start, we've got some questions that our YouTube audience have written in. The first is from Raj, and they have asked, who was your Premier League inspiration when you were growing up?
Thierry Henry. He's the one that sort of made me fall in love with football and just expressing yourself and having that sort of bit of uniqueness that just makes you different on the pitch. So, yeah, no, definitely him. Mm.
Next is Noah Jurgens, who said, what's your favourite skill to use in a 1v1 against a defender?
I think probably just a step over. I think maybe one or two step overs to try and gain half a yard. Yeah, no, I must be getting old because I don't think I've used the skill in a while, to be honest. Just kick and run or pass it, yeah.
Who's the toughest Premier League defender you've ever played against?
I think like my early days, I think Ivanovic, he was just so aggressive and how he wanted to sort of defend. I think it's out of him and probably Kyle Walker as well. You know, he's unbelievable pace, he's strong, he's quick. But sometimes it's not always about defending. Sometimes when they win the ball, they pass it and then you just see them sort of sprinting off in the distance. You're kind of like, give me a chance. I think probably out of those two, but I think modern day, I'd say Kyle Walker.
Okay, next is from Daniel Hansen. They said, how have the young players that have joined Southampton, like Tino, Livramento, Armando Broja and Nathan Teller, improved the squad?
I think they've brought some a little bit of naivety, but in a good way. They're almost freedom to express themselves, especially Tino. You know, he's come in at the start of the season and he's been fantastic. He's got something. And I think once he starts to think a little bit more about the game, he's going to be a top player.
The next one's from the Saints man. They've asked, who is the best at FIFA on the Southampton squad?
I think Moose is quite good. I think Kyle's not bad, Kyle Walker-Peters. I'd probably say a few of the young boys are quite decent at it as well, like Nathan Teller, Armando.
Okay, and the last question is from Ander. And they've asked, who is the fastest player at the club? It must be between you, Long and Tino.
Do you know what? Everyone thinks I'm fast. I'd probably be like fifth on the list, to be honest. But I think if it was a straight foot race, I think it's probably Nathan Teller and Adam Armstrong, yeah.
So if you put them in a race together, who's winning?
I think Nathan Teller, yeah. No, I think Nathan Teller, yeah.
You've got 10 minutes to go until full time. Your side is 2-1 down. Which Premier League Southampton legend are you going to bring in to help equalise or win the game?
Matt Letizia. Yeah, easy. It's no brain. I don't think it needs explaining either.
No explanation.
He's going for goal again. Oh! As only Matthew Letizia can score goals like that. As only he would even think of trying to score.
Growing up, watching sort of videos of him doing what he did for this club.
Brilliant goal!
I think it's a no-brainer. I'm still waiting for him to be on Ultimate Team, to be honest. I'm surprised he's not on it.
Okay, next one is, you're 2-0 down against your local rivals. Mm. Do you bring on an extra defender to help not let any more goals in, or are you going to bring in an attack to try and get the score up?
Yeah, I'll just go for it. It makes sense. I think we've done that a few times. Go for the jugular, might as well.
Okay, next one is, which young player from the Southampton squad will be the highest rated player in 5 years' time?
Ooh, it's a tough one, that. I'll say Tino, I think. Yeah, I think Tino is an all-round package. In 5 years, it'd be 24, we said?
Yeah.
He's got bundles of time, yeah. I think Tino.
If you could pick any player from Southampton, past or present, to play on the opposite wing with you, who would you pick?
I think I'd bring Dusan back. Yeah, I played with Dusan when I first came here and he was probably one of the players who helped sort of tune some of the things about thinking about the game a little bit more. He wasn't the quickest, he's definitely one of the strongest, and sometimes it seemed like he'd float in games, but his impact in games would always sort of stand out, and I think just the subtle things he did definitely helped me, whether it be visually or him showing me, definitely helped me sort of improve, so I'd definitely bring him back in.
And the last question is, at the end of the season, where do you think Southampton will finish and who will be the top scorer?
I think Shea will be the top scorer. Like Gaffer call him a ketchup ball. Once you sort of smack the top, it starts all coming out. So I think Shea will definitely be top goal scorer. I think if we aim to finish 11th, 12th, 13th, in between that sort of bracket, I think we can consider it a good season, hopefully trying to match what we've done in previous seasons.
Okay, so the first goal is Norwich, when you were still at Norwich, versus Southampton, 2013/14 season.
Do
Garrido in support. Redmond might not need him here. Redmond takes it on. Fabulous flashing finish. Norwich City have a new hero. First Premier League goal for Nathan Redmond.
I can remember it. I remember the feeling. I think that was Prowsey who I come again. I said that was one of my favourite skill moves. A sort of step over. Football was very, very instinctive. Mm-hmm. I just remember sort of picking up the ball there from Leroy and just thinking, let's try and get into a position where we can create a chance. It's easier when you get here, Prowsey's sort of come over. So when you get a centre midfielder trying to sort of defend, it's easier to get past them than it is to get past a fullback or an all-round defender. So when you get people in those sort of positions, you can generally tend to let off a shot and tuck a whim. Prowsey definitely remembers that. 100% Prowsey remembers that.
So the second is Southampton versus Huddersfield.
Oh, I remember this.
Redmond wants to shoot! Oh, goodness me! Nathan Redmond with another for the collection!
Yeah, that's not bad though. To be fair, I was in a really good place there. I think we just had the end of season awards. I picked up a few awards, sort of player of the season, fans and players player. I'd had a trip, I think, to Ghana. I think I was going to Ghana the next day with my right to play sort of family. And I just sort of went into this game. There was nothing really to play for, but I kind of wanted to finish the season on a high. And I think when I've cut in here, as Ingsy's played me the ball, I'm sort of half looking to sort of play him again. But once I realised the run's too deep, again, I'm in that situation where a centre midfielder's come over to help the fullback out. That opens up a little bit of a gap to have a shot, and I think that one's a little bit better than the first one.
So the last one is your goal against Burnley from last season.
Great save! Straight to Walcott. Redmond!
Oh, what a finish, son.
3-2 Southampton!
If the stadium's full, that's a much better goal.
Yeah, I was going to say, obviously no fans.
Yeah, but we were 2-0 down, I think, and we couldn't really figure out why, because we were playing so well. Mm-hmm. And it's always difficult playing against Burnley because, you know, they're very, very organised. We'd come back from 2 goals down. I just remember being in this game thinking at some point we may get another chance. And I think just before I've had this strike, Ingsy, I was thinking to myself, Ingsy's got to play me here. But Ingsy does what Ingsy does and gets himself out of tight spaces and has a shot. And Theo's sort of had the composure and showed his experience to see me at the back post. And I just thought if I can control the volley, you know, as they say, hard and low, then it'll have a chance and it's gone in. And then that's the game, 3-2, and a successful day at the office.
What is your favourite goal that you've ever scored?
The first one that comes to mind of recent would be Chelsea away. It was more of a team goal, but it was more of one that sort of brings me joy because, you know, how I envision football to be played was just epitomises sort of that goal, and it's stuff which you see sort of the top teams play, stringing, you know, 17, 18, 19 passes together. It was a very, very simple finish and one where, you know, I probably was expected to score, but I think just the whole aspect of that goal was probably definitely one of my favourites. And I think it was like the day, I think it was Boxing Day, I think it was the day after Christmas as well, so, you know, the festive period, it made everything a little bit better.
So we've got your FIFA 22 item behind us. You did sigh when you looked at it. So.
53 physical, that is mad. If we look through a lot of games, it's very, very rare I get pushed off the ball or I get bullied. So I think that needs to change. 70 passing, that's a bit mad. I'm not a centre mid, so it's understandable. 81 dribbling, I think it's kind of fair. Defending 30, am I that bad at defending? Am I that bad? I think my attacking stuff, I can say, okay, that's fair. But the defending and physical, I need to talk to them.
What do you think it should be overall? What do you think your rating should be?
At least 91.
91?
No, I'm joking. No, I think 76 is fair. 76 is fair. I'd take an 80. Do you know what though? These cards don't really mean nothing, innit? What you need to do, if you're a player, play well, get man of the match. Card goes up. You know how many people DM me saying, oh, every time I've got a man of the match and it comes up on FIFA or if I've played really well and a new card's coming out, they're like, oh my God, your card's amazing. You're doing so well for me on FIFA. I'm like, all right, well, that settles it then. So if you play Ultimate Team, don't buy this one. Wait until I play really well.